In this Binance tutorial, I'm going to show you everything that you need to know to get started on Binance and safely purchase your first Bitcoin, Ethereum, or other cryptocurrencies. This is a complete and detailed guide for beginners getting started in crypto. So if you're looking for a step-by-step tutorial on Binance, then this is the right video for you. I'll break down this video into small sections where I will show you the sign-up and verification process, then how to buy and trade your crypto, and also show you how to withdraw your funds from your Binance account. And as a bonus, towards the end of this video, I will show you how to earn some passive income using your Binance account. So make sure to stick with me to the end. But for now, let's get started. The first step is to sign up for a new Binance account, and I recommend you click on this link in the description below or type this into your browser. It'll take you to my special Binance sign up page where you'll get an extra 10% off your Binance trading fees if you don't have an account yet. So from the sign up page, you can create your account with your email address or your mobile number. And I'll go for the email option in this tutorial. And the last thing before proceeding, to make sure you get your 10% discount on your fees, you need to make sure that you input this referral code into this field, and you'll see here the kickback rate, it says 10%. And once that comes up, you're guaranteed for your discount. Now we can click on create account, pull this slide bar to the correct position. Now you'll be sent a 6-digit number to your email address that you signed up with. So you'll need to input that and confirm your account. So here's what your confirmation email will look like, and this is the 6-digit number that you'll need to copy over. So now we paste it into here, and we are successfully taken through to Binance. Now we want to click on go to dashboard, and you'll be asked to go through an extra step of security verification. And you can either choose the phone verification method or the Google verification method. I suggest you go with the Google verification, as it is an app on your phone which will continuously generate new verification codes. Whereas the phone verification method will be the same phone number, so it's more prone to hackers. You can choose what you want in the end, but I'm going to go through the Google verification method here. So we click on Google verification, and now you'll be presented with an option to download this app either through the App Store for your iPhone or the Google Play Store for your Android mobile phone. So I have an Android, and I'll click on Google Play, and this is the app I'm going to install on my phone. Once you have installed that, you can click on Next, and now we want to scan the QR code from our Google Authenticator app, which we just downloaded. Click Next. And next one more time. Now we'll click here to get our code from our email address one more time. Type that in and type in our new Google verification code and click submit. And you can see here our two-factor authentication has been verified. If we scroll down, you can see once you deposit your funds, your fiat and crypto balance will show up here. And before we go any further, I want to guide you through some security features that are important to know. So we click on security, and you can see here, first of all, we just finished setting up our Google authentication, and you can also set up the SMS authentication as well if you want to. It is never a bad idea to have more verification steps than not. And if you want a physical security key sent to you at home, you can also set up this YubiKey with Binance. But for me, that's not quite necessary. Another good thing that I recommend you set up is the whitelist option. If you turn this on and add in all the known crypto addresses that you want to be able to send to, then any new addresses will have to be verified through your Google authentication before being able to send. So this is really good to protect you from hackers. If they log into your account, they will not be able to transfer your crypto or your funds anywhere else. The next thing is the anti-phishing code. I also recommend you set this up, as it allows you to spot whether your email that you receive from Binance is real or fake. So we click on create phishing code and just type in something memorable to you. And then click on submit, put in your Google authenticator code one more time, and that's been created now. So the next step is to do your identity verification. We can go back to security and click on verify. Now this step is only required if you want to deposit or withdraw your fiat currency. If you're only trading crypto, then you don't need to do this at all. Now we pick a residential country here and click on verify now. Put your personal information in, and there it is. My account has been verified to the basic level. But you can see here, depending on what country you're from, different levels allow you to buy a different amount of crypto. So for example, with this one, if you're just on the basic, you're only allowed to buy $300 lifetime. So if you want any more than that, you'll need to verify to the next level. But to verify, you will require to have either your passport or ID card, a picture of you, and also facial verification. So now that we have fully verified our personal details, we are now ready to go and purchase our cryptocurrencies. And there are two main ways of doing this on Binance. The first method is fast but has higher fees, and the second method is slower but has much lower fees. So it's up to you on which method you want to go for, but I'll show you both of these now. So the first method, we'll go to buy crypto and click on credit/debit card. This will bring us to a page where you can choose the currency that you want to sell and the currency that you want to buy. So in this case is US dollars, but if you deposited other fiat currencies like Australian dollar, you can always choose that instead like this. But I'm happy with USD, so I'll go back and choose that. And we want to buy Bitcoin in this case, so I'll just leave this as BTC. Now you can buy your assets in two ways. You can think of it in terms of dollars or in terms of Bitcoin. So you can buy $100 worth of Bitcoin if you want, or you can buy a certain amount of Bitcoin. Like if I want to buy 0.03 Bitcoin, it's going to cost me $118.86. So if I'm happy with that, then I'll click on continue. And now we're going to have to add our credit or debit card details. Remember that if you have not verified your personal information, you won't be able to access this page. That step will have to be completed beforehand. Anyway, I'm now going to click on add new card. And once your card is added, click on continue. It'll take you to the summary page where you can see how much Bitcoin you're going to get, how much money you're going to spend, and what your total fees are going to be. So you can see in this case the fees are around 2%, and it can go up as high as 3.5% using this payment method of the debit or credit card. So that's fairly expensive, right? But all in all, if you're only buying a few $100 worth of Bitcoin, the difference in fees isn't going to be that much. So I'd still suggest you go for this method. However, if you intend on buying thousands or hundreds of thousands of dollars worth of Bitcoin, then I recommend you go for the second method, which is going to cut down on your fees by a big margin. Here's a quick question for you. What percentage of your portfolio do you plan on holding in Bitcoin and why? Let me know in the comments section below. So for the second method, you go to buy crypto and click on bank deposit. And you can see here right away, for my US dollars currency, it's going to be $0 in fees. And it's the same for other currencies like the Australian dollar, it's all free. And once you have deposited your fiat into Binance, the fees to actually go and purchase your Bitcoin is where you're going to make the big savings. And from this table, you can see that our fee can be reduced down to as little as 0.075% if you choose the Binance coin to pay your fees. This is roughly a 4 to 5 times saving in fees. So it can really add up if you're buying a lot of Bitcoin. So now we can click on continue, select the amount we want to deposit, click on continue again, click confirm, and you will see the bank account information of Binance here. So this is where you have to log in to your bank account and make a bank transfer to Binance. And you must click here and copy all these account details one by one and make sure you input it correctly. And a reference code here at the bottom is very, very important to add into your bank transfer to make sure that your payment arrives on Binance correctly. One quick note is that once you deposit your US dollar, it's going to turn up into your Binance account as BUSD. This is the Binance version of the US dollar. So just remember that as a note for when you go to the next step and make the transfer. And you can also see here, it's going to take 2 to 4 business days, which is what I told you before. It will take a little bit more time, but you're going to save a lot on the fees. So once our fiat currency has arrived into account, we're ready to go and swap it out for Bitcoin. And to do that, you would click on trade and go to convert. And in this case, we would select our BUSD. Click on that. But if you deposited other currencies like the Australian dollar, you can type in AUD instead and choose that. And now let's say I want to trade my $1,000 into Bitcoin, and now click on preview, and here's what I'm going to get. And if you're happy with everything, then you can click on convert, and that's it. So this part is as easy as the first method. But if you're more advanced and want to set some orders below this current price, or set some take profit orders as well above the price, then you'll need to go to the advanced section. And to do that, we'll go to trade and click on advance. Do you like the level of detail I'm providing in my Binance tutorial so far? If yes, make sure to let me know by liking my video. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel so you don't miss out on more quality content that I'll be releasing every single week. And it will take you to this dashboard here where you can see on the left-hand side is the candlestick chart where it is connected to TradingView, and you can do some technical analysis and draw lines and things like that before you buy to make a better informed decision. And in the middle is your order book, and on the right-hand side is where you can click buy and sell your asset. And there are 3 different types of orders: the limit, market, and stop limit. The next thing we want to do is go to this arrow here and go to fiat. And under fiat, I'm going to choose the BUSD because that's what I deposited. But if you added a different currency like the Australian dollar or the euro, then you would click on these buttons here instead. But I'll click on BUSD. And now I want to scroll down to BTC, right? Because we want to buy Bitcoin. So I click there, and that's the trading pair that I want to choose. So now that we've got the right pairing, you can go ahead and go to market and type in, let's say $100 I want to buy worth of Bitcoin, and you simply just click on buy BTC. And this will execute a market order and purchase the closest value on your order book immediately for you. And it will show your BTC balance available will be more than zero. It'll be the $100 that we bought. So now that you know how to deposit your fiat currency into your Binance and converting them into crypto, I'm now going to show you how to deposit crypto into your Binance account. So from our wallet and overview page, you can go to deposit here and click on deposit crypto. So from the top, you can see the coin here selected that you want to deposit. If you want to deposit something else, like Ethereum, then you can click here and type in ETH for Ethereum here, or a different currency like Cardano, or any other currency that you wish. But for this example, we'll just choose Bitcoin. Now moving over to the right, you can see the different blockchains that Binance supports. So first of all, BTC is on the left, and then you have the two Binance chains here, and followed by the ERC20, which is an Ethereum blockchain. So it's very important to get this exactly right, so the address is correct. So obviously with BTC here, you're only gonna have the BTC option or BTC SegWit. So make sure you don't select the wrong blockchain. And if, for example, you wanna select Ethereum, then you wanna make sure ERC20 is clicked so that it gives you the correct address for that blockchain. It's absolutely vital that you use the correct blockchain and the exact address copied. So you can click here to copy your address. If you don't do this and miss out on a letter or use the wrong blockchain, your funds that you want to deposit may be lost forever. Now, if you're using an exchange or a mobile app and you want to just scan this code, then you can just hover over here and scan the barcode to copy this address as well. So now I'm going to show you an example of where you would put this address. So we just click on copy. And right here, I'm simply using my KuCoin account as an example. So once I select BTC to withdraw, then in this wallet address section, I would just click here and simply paste in my address, which I copied from Binance, put in the amount and then confirm. And it's that simple. And one quick tip is I always make sure to check that the first two or three letters and the last two or three is the same. So here's 13RE, and I just double check 13RE and then I press confirm. Another thing to note is that when you're transferring cryptos from one account to another, there will always be a fee. Some may be higher, some may be smaller, but there will be some sort of fee involved. So now that you're fully up to date with depositing your fiat currency or cryptocurrency into your Binance account, let's go through how to withdraw your crypto and fiat currency out of Binance. Now from your homepage, you want to go to wallet and click on overview. You want to go and click on withdraw here. And now we're going to select crypto, as that's what we're going to talk about first. So now you can see by clicking on here, the different cryptocurrency assets that you can withdraw. So in this case here, I'm going to select Ethereum, and you can either scroll down to find it or type in Ethereum here and it will come up. And now comes the most important part, the actual address. You really need to get this right word for word, otherwise your funds may be lost. And also the network must be correct. So I'll give you an example on my KuCoin account. If I go to assets and go to my account, similarly to the Binance account, and then I type in ETH for Ethereum and then click on deposit, this will give me the Ethereum address that I'll need. And you can see here, the best way is to copy it by clicking on this button here. Or if you're on your mobile phone and you can scan a QR code, then you can hover over here and scan that QR code there. And then we would simply just go back to our Binance account and click on the address, and then we would paste in the actual address. A quick tip here is that I always make sure that the first three letters and the last three letters are exactly the same before I move on to the next step. And now for the network, we click here and we want to select the ERC20 for Ethereum, as that's the Ethereum network. And we want to make sure that we use the right blockchain, because if you don't, your funds will be lost. So for Ethereum, you know that it's ERC20, so you must select this Ethereum blockchain. And you can see there's a network fee of $9. So this fee can't be avoided, as it's a gas fee required to transfer your cryptocurrency. So we click that, select the amount we want, and if you're happy with everything, then you can click on withdraw here. Let's move on to withdrawing fiat. So we would go back to wallet, click on overview, and back to withdraw. And we would go up to here and select withdraw fiat. This will bring up a window where you can select the currency that you want to withdraw. It may be Euro, Australian dollars, or the US dollar. And for this example, I'll select USD. And now we can see here, I have my funds available to be transferred out. But if you don't and you still have your holdings in Bitcoin or other cryptocurrencies, then you'll need to go to trade and click on convert or the advanced section to trade back from your crypto to your fiat currency. And if you need more help on the convert section or the advanced section, then I have this tutorial for you here, which will guide you through that step by step. And another thing I have to mention is you won't be able to withdraw any fiat currency or deposit if you haven't done your personal verification step yet. Once you're verified, we just select the amount that we want to withdraw. Let's say $500. You can see there's a flat $30 transaction fee, no matter how much you withdraw. So the fees can add up if you're doing small amount at a time. But once you're happy with the amount and the fees, then you can click on continue. And this will be the last step that you have to do, which is to enter in your actual bank details. So your name cannot be changed. You must withdraw to your own bank account in your own name. Now you fill out the rest of the details and then click on confirm withdrawal once you're happy with everything. So the next thing I want to show you about Binance is the Binance Earn program. So this is a really cool way that you can earn some free interest on the cryptocurrency that you're currently holding on Binance. So it's kind of like a bank savings account, but for cryptocurrencies. So we want to go to finance and click on Binance Earn. So you can see here, if we scroll down straight away, there's a lot of different products that Binance have, like the BNB vaults, normal staking, fixed term savings, and flexible savings. I won't go through each of these in details right now, but I have a fully dedicated video here which guides you through all of this Binance Earn step by step. So check that out if you want more information. But let's go down and take a look at one of them here. So I'm just going to pick the savings one for now. Click on view more and it will take me to my Binance savings page where you can see that they are flexible and locked savings where you can transfer your funds into these pools to start earning interest. For example, if we have some BUSD and we want to earn some interest on that, by going to the flexible savings option, you'll get a 2.19% APY. But if we go down to the locked savings, then you're going to earn 5.31% APY. So you can see by locking your assets for a certain amount of time, you're going to earn more interest. So if I go to 14 days, it's even more, 30 and 90 can go up to as high as 6%. So that is a worthwhile thing to do, I believe, especially if you're holding your crypto assets on Binance. But if you're not going to make use of this Binance Earn, then I recommend you transfer all your crypto into your own crypto wallet, as this will be the safest way of storing your cryptocurrency. So if you're ready to proceed with Binance and want to know the next step you should take, then I recommend you check out this video next. But if you think that the Binance exchange is not the right one for you, then I recommend this alternative. So check them out and I'll see you in the next tutorial.